In today's video, we're going to talk about our AccuRip settings. Coming up. Hey, welcome back everybody. Matt with Mikey Designs here. By special request, we had someone ask what our AccuRip settings are. I am going to go ahead and show you. Let's go ahead and dive into the desktop preview here. So I'm going to go ahead and open up AccuRip really quick. This is the artwork that we are going to print out. This is a job that we're going to work on today. It's just a simple spot color. It's going to be white, one simple spot color. And let me show you our settings. So I'm going to click on this little button here in the top right-hand corner and go to Edit Configuration. As you can see here, we have an Epson 1430. We do use sheet film, waterproof film. So I have the media type set to sheet. The size that we do use is 13 by 19. We have an all black ink setup. It's a multi-black is how it goes by here in AccuRip. So we have that selected. Essentially every single one of the colors, cyan, magenta, yellow, black, light cyan, light magenta, they all have black ink in them. Now for the printer setup and the print resolution, I like to keep ours at 1440 by 720, and then the droplet weight at 6. And the reason I use 6 is because it doesn't waste too much ink and it produces a nice dense film. And then this is something that I change regularly depending on what the job is. For this particular job, I'm going to keep it round. Ellipse is fine, sometimes diamond's fine, but I tend to stick to round. I keep my angle at 22.5. And for this particular job, because we're going to use a 195 mesh, I'm going to set that at 42 LPI, and then I'm going to hit OK. So, I mean, it's pretty simple. There are our settings for AccuRip. Now I'm going to hit Command P. You could hit Control P for you guys out there and you gals that have a PC. The settings here, it's set to AccuRip. When you have AccuRip in a Macintosh or even a PC, your printer is going to be AccuRip to whatever printer you have. In output, we have it set to separations. So that way, with the spot color that we have designated for the white, it's only going to print that spot color. Now, if it were set to composite, because I do like to make my white spot colors have some cyan, it probably would just print cyan, really, and it wouldn't be 100%. So this is our little spot color. It's going to make this an opaque black once we print it out. I'm going to go ahead and hit print, and we'll show you how the film comes out. Okay, so here is our film. It is nice and opaque. As I look through it, I can't see any light coming through. And we'll put a link down in the description as to what film we are actually using here. But this film has worked out really well for us. I was even having streaks in some of the other film I was using. And this is pretty inexpensive. So we'll be sure to check that out down in the description. So as you can see, holding it up to the light, that is very opaque. You can't even see Panda's face back there. And so those are our settings to get a nice opaque film. And that's about it, guys. Don't forget to subscribe. Hit the little subscribe button over here if you're new to the channel. Be sure to check out some of our other videos. I never know which way this thing goes. And until next time, guys, we'll see you later. Okay.